The Bible was burned because it was believed that if the lay people have the Bible, they're going to come up with all kinds of various doctrines that are wrong. Luther was willing to take that risk. Wycliffe was willing to take that risk because there is some truth to that, isn't there? I mean, you give somebody a Bible alone and he's starting to build his own theology, he can sure go wrong quite quickly. And that's why we have to look back over how some of the past teachers have interpreted it, and we learn from them. But at the same time, what Luther said is, I want the plowman to be able to understand the Bible. He said, I want the woman who scrubs floors, I want her to understand the Bible. I want her to have a copy. And this was absolutely revolutionary, and that's why there was so much opposition.
It's the power, the sufficiency of Scripture. And you let it loose into your life, your children's lives, your friends' lives, your neighbors' lives, and it has such power to change and convert. And this is what happened wholesale in the continent of Europe during the Reformation, as people began for the first time to be able to read the gospel. And those who couldn't read, others read it to them in a language they could understand, the common, ordinary language. This is what shook the continent and our religious structures to their core, was getting the word into their hands and hearts.